Hey guys, it's Jang here from the unofficial LEGO Hero Factory Mox blog and Bionicle Untold. In this video, I'm looking at the 2011 Hero Factory Hero EVO 2.0. It's set number 2067. He's a brand new character. He is the one that uses purple. I know a lot of people have been looking for purple. So here we go. Let's open up the box or the canister, see what's inside. The instruction set goes to page 18, like almost all of the heroes do. And I'm gonna go straight for what most folks have been looking for with this set, the purple. Oh God, purple. That's it. Three pieces, three small little pieces in purple. That's what you get. So as for the rest of it, there's a little bit of purple on his unique armor piece also. As for the rest of it, armor is in a medium yellow. This is a pretty classic LEGO color. It's not the brightest yellow that they make. It's just a kind of a standard color that you would see used for minifig hands and heads and such. Pretty cool color. And he has the minifig sized spears, except they are rubber and they're made in a silver color. These are going to be used in his weapon, and these are two other parts for his weapon also. These are new for him. Of course, all of the heroes use the new style of ball and socket connectors. Here's just a few of them that are used with this particular set. And unfortunately, the smaller ones do not have any pin holes in them, and none of them have any axle holes. You pretty much are forced to just use balls and sockets to connect things. If you want to get axle holes, you'll have to connect something else, such as one of these sort of parts. But let's go ahead and get into the build and see what this figure is really going to look like once he's all put together. There's your basic stick figure skeleton that's used for all of the heroes. It's all of your joints and all of your main stability and connectivity for the whole body plugs into this. Weapon goes together, and these spikes plug in through the ends just like that. That's a weapon. The main part of the hero body consists of this basic armor piece that goes underneath. That's the same size and shape for all of them, but they change the color a little bit. This one's in the dark pearl gray. Then you put a chest plate over that, which ties into the color scheme of the figure. And then you have a hero core. Hero cores are not compatible with the old ones. You can't put the old ones in these chest plates. You can't put the new ones in the old armor. The final step is to assemble the head. And it's three pieces instead of what we're used to with two in the past. You've got the almost Glatorian style or Glatorian inspired head, not translucent. Here it is in its exclusive purple color. It's not available on any of the other figures just yet. It has a ball socket underneath. It's hollow inside. And you put the accessory piece in there. It uses two mini pins, followed by the skull cap or the helmet, small helmet. Again, uses two smaller pins. There you go. That's your head. And then you attach it. So there he is in full, EVO 2.0, all fully assembled. Cool looking set. He's got the opposing colors, the highly contrasting colors of medium yellow and the purple. Not a whole lot of purple is actually used in the set, but it has certainly grabbed the attention of a lot of LEGO fans. It's got the same basic body with lots of motion and articulation that all of the new heroes do, which is awesome. You can pose them in just about any way. Lots of just flexibility thanks to both the joints as well as the armor itself. You can see there's this dip in here, which, you know, you might want to just put a bar of, you know, a three pin piece right across in there, but then you lose the ability to do that. So pretty much everything is designed with a purpose. And the head here, you know, it's a head. I like the gunmetal gray or the dark pearl gray. The look of it, I think it's a subjective thing whether you like it or not. I think it works out all right. It sticks out a little bit far forward, but does give him a little bit of a fairly unique character. And then the weapon, I think it's one of the better looking weapons to use this part. I think they use this part too much, and I hope they don't continue to put that in a large number of the sets. But what's interesting is if you look on herofactory.com, on the official LEGO site, you will see that they call this a double-barreled ice cannon, which means that these represent spikes of ice shooting out, which raises the question, at least for me, why does EVO 2.0 have silver ice spikes while Stormer has blue ice spikes? If it's the exact same thing, why is it a different color? It's just one of those mysteries of the Hero Factory universe. But at any rate, oh yeah, and of course you've got the five-fingered or four fingers and a thumb hand here, which is cool. Only one of them though. No hand on this side. But there you go, EVO 2.0. This is my last individual hero review for the new Hero Factory 2011 series. Hope you enjoyed this. Hope you'll check out my reviews of the villains also. And also, I will be doing the combiners for all of these guys. For EVO 2.0, the combiner is used with Furno. Take a look at it. So I'll be building that up and see how that works out. Kind of a Titan hero, which is a new concept for 2011. Find that video coming up on my channel. It's LEGO Jang on YouTube. And also check out my posts on my blogs. And I'll talk to you again soon.